Om Gananam Tva Ganapatihum Havamahe Kavinka Veenam Upamashyavastamam Jeshtharajam Brahmanam Brahmanaspatana Shrunvannoti Vissida Sadhanam Shri Mahaganadipataye Namaha Guru Brahma Guru Vishnu Guru Devo Maheshwarah Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Om. Dear friends, we are seeing the Trupti Deepa Prakaranam, that is the 7th chapter of Vedanta Panchadashi. And in the last class, we read shloka number 48, 7th chapter, 7-48. And the context is, sage Vidyaranya, he is now talking about what is called Paroksha Jnanam and Aparoksha Jnanam. And Paroksha Jnanam, by this Paroksha Jnana, Brahma Nasti, that particular Brahma Nasti, not like that, Astitva, Astitva Shanka, Brahma, whether it is there or not, that particular Shanka is removed by that. And then, by Aparoksha Jnana, yes, Bhati, Nasti, Na Bhati. There are two aspects, Nasti, Brahma is not there, the tenth man is missing, etc., etc. Okay, tenth man is there. So that knowledge is achieved by Paroksha Jnana. Yes, Na Bhati, that particular thing is removed by, yes, Aparoksha Jnana. In that Aparoksha Jnana, yes, I am that. So that sort of realization comes. So Astitva and Bhanam, Astitvam and Bhanam both take place in this Paroksha Jnana and Aparoksha Jnana. So that is the overall context. And in that Aparoksha, after that Aparoksha Jnana, the result is that Shokani Vrutti is there and Atyantika Trupti, Nirankusha Bhavet Trupti, Nirankusha Bhavet Trupti, Nirankusha Trupti. So these are the effects. And in the 48th shloka he was saying, Aparoksha Jnana Shokani Vrutta Khe Ube Yime, these two avasthas. Avastha means that two stages called Aparoksha Jnana is one and Shokani Vrutti is another. So these things, Jivage Brute Atmanam Chediti Shrutihi, Jivage Brute Atmanam Chediti Shrutihi. So we are basically talking about that particular Shruti, Atmanam Chedvijani At Ayamasmiti Purushaha. So that is the Shruti. So that Shruti is basically to tell about, to tell you that this Aparoksha Jnana will remove all shoka from you. So that is what was the 48th shloka. Now we have to come to 49th shloka. In this 49th shloka, there is an avatarika. The avatarika is like this. We are talking about what is called the Aparokshatvam. So this Aparokshatvam is, though Atma is Swaprakasha, Atma is number one, Swaprakasha. We all agree that Atma is something for which, in order to explain or understand Atma, or rather, to know Atma, no other light is needed. Just as you don't need another light to see the lamp, you don't require another person to say that you exist, I exist. For example, I say I exist. I don't need anybody's certificate to say that I exist. I very much know. So this Atma is something which is Swayam Prakasha. But still, Buddhi also comes into play. Buddhi also comes into play, and because of Buddhi, we do what is called Atma Vichara. Till we do that Atma Vichara, we really do not know. So that is the basic issue here. Atma, of course, is Aparoksha. It is always existing. Aparokshataya, it is always existing in all the Jivas. But the Jiva, unless he does some Vichara, he will not realize. And how does he do Vichara? He has to do Vichara only by Buddhi. And when he does Vichara by Buddhi, initially it is seen as a Paroksha, and later it is becoming a Paroksha. So these are the stages which are there. So that is what he is going to say. Nanu, I am reading the Avatarika. Ayamiti Aparokshatvam ityatra, Ayamiti padena Atmano Aparokshatvam uktam. So, Ayamiti Aparokshatvam, that he is referring to that shloka number 21 in the same adhyaya. He is referring to that shloka number 21. Ayamiti Aparo, that is page 476 in our book, shloka number 21. Ayamiti Aparokshatvam uchyate chet tad uchyatam Swayam Prakasham Chaitanyam Aparoksham Sadayataha. Because the question is, when you say that I am Asmi, do you want to say that Atma is known as Aparoksham? That is the question. Do you want to say that Atma is known as Aparoksham? the answer there is Swayam Prakasham Chaitanyam Aparoksham. Yes, there is nothing wrong because it is always Swayam Prakasham, because the knower is you only. And Atma is Nitya Aparoksham. And Shruti also says Yat Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma. So Atma is Nitya Aparoksham, Nitya Aparoksham. So that is what he is referring to. Ayamitya Parokshatvam Ityatra. So he is referring to that particular shloka, Ayamitya Parokshatvam Uchetete Uchetad Uchetam. So tad nanu ayamitya parokshatvam ityatra ayamiti padena atmanah aparokshatvam chete ityuktam ayam asmi iti purushah. In that ayam asmi, that ayam is referring to that aparokshatvam. Aparokshatvam is being told. Ayam asmi, when you say ayam asmi, ayam asti we should normally say, but when we are saying ayam asmi, ayam means that I am, and we are saying, isn't it? When we say that I am, we are saying, yes, aparokshatvam, it is myself, it is not other than me. Aparokshatvam achade ityuktam. Tathasati, aparokshatva jnana vishayatvam eva syat, na paroksha jnana vishayatvam. If it is so, let it be aparoksham only. Why should it be paroksha? You see this line, tathasati, aparoksha jnana vishayatvam eva syat, na paroksha jnana vishayatvam. If you say that Atma is aparoksham, let it be treated as aparoksham only. Then why do you say that it is paroksham? Ityashankya. Tad upapadanaya aparokshajnanam vibhajate. In order to upapadana, upapadana means to explain it, to postulate it, or to hypothesize it. He is now dividing this aparokshajnanam. Aparokshajnanam is at two levels, he says. Aparokshajnanam is two levels. So because of that, we are saying that yes, there is what is called Parosha Jnanam also. So let us see the shloka. Ayamitya Parokshatva Muktam Tadvividham Bhavet Vishayasva Prakashatvat Dhiya Pyevam Tadikshanat. Ayam iti Aparokshatvam Uktam. Yes, I am Asmi iti Aparokshatvam Uktam. That I am. You are saying that yes, I am that. Iti Aparokshatvam Uktam. Aparoksham is something which is directly known. Paroksha is something which is not known. Paroksha is something, for example, we talk about Swarga. Swarga we have not seen, but we do accept. That is what is called Paroksha Jnana. And when we say, yes, I am, you are that Brahman. So initially we don't feel it. Then after this Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana and all that, then we slowly come to feel, yes, there is something in this. I look like Brahman only. So that aparoksha jnana, it dawns slowly and slowly, it dawns. And of course, Shruti also says aparoksha jnana, it comes like a spark. So that also may also be there. But aparoksha jnana slowly sinks into that. So that is the reason why they also talk about jnana abhyasa. Jnana abhyasa, why do you do jnana abhyasa if it all of a sudden it reveals like some sort of lightning? Suddenly, in a flash, you become realized. Then where is the question of jnana abhyasa? So jnana abhyasa also is needed. Maybe for some people, some lucky people, that sort of sudden realization may be there. We do not know. But for most of the people, jnana abhyasa is very much needed. So here, ayamiti aparokshatva muktam, tat dvividham bhavet. Dvividham means there are two levels. We can say two kinds or two levels. Dividham is actually two kinds or two levels also we can say. Then Vishaya Swaprakashatvat Dhiya Pyevam Tadichanat. Vishaya Swaprakashatvat means because the Atma is something which is always aparoksha, so that is always accepted. But it is also Dhiya Api. Dhiya Api means by means of Buddhi also. Dhiya Api Evam Tad Ikshanat. Even by Buddhi, it is also known. Because Atma, how is it known? Initially, Atma is known only by Buddha, Akhandakara Vritti. You go to a teacher, and that teacher, he tells you the Upanishad Vakya, and that Upanishad Vakya, then again we do Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. In addition to that, simultaneously, there is some purity of mind which has to go on. That is, we have to get rid of all this raga, dvesha and all these things, and mind has to be neutralized. And it is only when the mind becomes totally neutralized, that is mano, nasha, vasana, kshaya and all those things take place, then only this thing sinks into us, yes, I am that. Till that time, okay, however learned we may be, it doesn't sink. So unless that internal purification comes, it doesn't sink. So then, now buddhi also is having a role. It is not as though buddhi is not having a role. Buddhi also is having a role here, because it is through mind we are doing that vichara. We also know the line, mana eva manushyanam karanam bandhamokshayoho, isn't it? The mind is responsible for bondage and also for liberation. Mind is responsible for bondage because mind is, it is going after all these vishayas. That is bahirmukha. In that bahirmukha mode, it is going after vishayas and then you are getting bound. And when that becomes antarmukha, and then when it starts contemplating on the nature or analyzing the nature of what is the reality, then yes, mind also becomes mind, goes up to the level of akhandakara vritti. Of course, Vidyaranya is going to say later in the same adhyaya, he is going to talk about this akhandakara vritti, vritti vyapyam, phala vyapyam. We have come across these words. In some other context we have come across in some bhashyam. So anyway, those things we are going to see. So here what he says is, vishayasya, vishaya swaprakashatvat, means vishayasya swaprakashatvat, because this vishaya, this atma is, what is the vishaya? Vishaya is the atma only. Atma is something which is self-evident, which is always there. And dhiya api evam tadichanat, even by the mind, it is realized by means of akhandakara vritti is there, by means of that akhandakara vritti. So, vishaya swaprakashatvat means that I exist, he is known to us without any sort of external aid. There is no need for anybody to say that. So, let us see the commentary here. Ayam iti iti. Paroksha jnana vibhajate ayam iti iti. Dvaividhye karanamaha. Dvaividhyam. Dvaividhyam means that sort of two levels or duality, let us say. Dvaividhyam. Two kinds. Karanamaha. Is vishayasya chidrupasya atmanaha swaprakashatvena. So this vishaya is what? Chidrupa atma. Chidrupa atma is vishaya. So chidrupasya atmanaha swaprakashatvat. It is totally self-evident. Number two is tad ikshanat, buddhya tad ikshanat, vishayasya atmanaha avalokanachya. Vishayasya atmanaha atmano avalokanachya. And it is also being seen, it is also being known by the buddhi. Akhandakara vritti is something which is there, that we are referring to that vritti here. Then, so that is atma is known as a vishaya, is also paroksha jnana. And atma is initially known by the mind as paroksha and later as aparoksha. And when the mind, or rather vritti, also dissolves, when the vritti also dissolves, then it is known aparoksha. So that is what the two levels he is talking about. So this shloka is ayamity aparokshatva muktam tad vividham bhavet. So in that aparokshatva he is making a slight distinction. Vishaya is no doubt, it is swaprakasha. But buddhi also is having a role. Buddhi also is having a role because it is the buddhi which is meditating or doing that atma vichara. And that buddhi is going to that level of akhandakara vritti. And when that buddhi vritti drops off, all that he has not told, he is going to say later. When that buddhi vritti drops off, then naturally you will realize. So this sort of, these two levels we can visualize in that. Then that first level, the second level, the buddhya pyevam tadichanat becomes, that is paroksha jnana. Buddhya he is realizing. When you do atma vichara and when the akhandakara vritti, that is you are saying, yes, atma asti. So we are at that level, paroksha jnana level only. So the next shloka he is going to say the same thing. Next shloka avatarika is bhavatu dvaividhyam. Bhavatu dvaividhyam means, we accept that there are two levels. Yetavata paroksha jnana vishayatve kimayatam iti ashankya. So by this paroksha jnana vishayatve kimayatam, why then paroksha, when you are postulating this thing called paroksha jnana, then what is it you are going to achieve? What is it you are going to achieve or understand better? Whenever some point is analyzed, why is it analyzed? In order to understand a point in a better way. So by saying that, how are you going to understand it in a better way? So kimayatam ityashankya. Vishaya swaprakashatvam paroksha jnana vishayitva virohi na bhavati. That is, vishaya swaprakashatvam paroksha jnana vishayitva virohi na bhavati. Okay. So this Vishaya is Svaprakasham, but at the same time it is not opposed to Paroksha Jnana. Paroksha Jnana Vishayatva Virodhi. Paroksha Jnana Vishayatva means it is also a subject matter for Paroksha Jnana. It is also a subject matter for Aparoksha Jnana. Atma is something which is also a subject matter for Paroksha Jnana and also subject matter for Aparoksha Jnana. So Vishaya Svaprakashatvam Paroksha Jnana Vishayatva Virodhi Na Bhavati. It is not contradicting. It is like let us go back to that example of 10th man. So even though you are the 10th man, or rather even though a person is a 10th man, he came to know it through buddhi. That is, paroksha jnanam was needed because of his ignorance, isn't it? And that paroksha jnanam is not opposed to the aparoksha jnanam. When he realizes, yes, I am the 10th man, so that paroksha jnanam is not something which is opposed to that aparoksha jnanam. So that is what he is saying. So long as we do not know at all, though I am the 10th man, I don't know. Then suddenly somebody comes and says, so that paroksha jnanam is there. That paroksha jnanam becomes aparoksha. So that paroksha jnanam is not contradicting, or it is not opposed to aparoksha jnanam. Or rather, this Atma is such a thing that it is initially known by paroksha jnana and later aparoksha jnana. So that paroksha jnana is not something which is contradicting this aparoksha jnana. So that is what he is saying. Vishaya svaprakashatvam paroksha jnana vishayatva virodhi na bhavati. It is not contradicting that. Let us see the shloka. Paroksha jnana kalepi vishaya svaprakashata sama brahma svaprakasham asti ityevam vibodhanat. So what he is saying is, this brahma, or with reference to jiva, what we call kutastha, that kutastha is something which is self-luminous even at the time of that indirect knowledge or paroksha jnana. Kutastha is always kutastha. There is no change in that kutastha. It is always self-luminous even when you are ignorant and even when you come to the level of paroksha jnana. Even at the level of paroksha jnana, the kutastha continues to be self-luminous only. So that is what he says. It is equally shining, equally self-luminous at the time of paroksha jnana. Paroksha jnana kalepi, even at the time of this paroksha jnana. So paroksha jnanam also is not easy. Paroksha jnanam happens after a lot of shravana manana and what not. So even at that time, Vishaya Svaprakashata Sama. So this Sama has to be connected to this first line. Vishaya Svaprakashata Sama. Sama means it is equally there. It is always there. Vishaya Svaprakashata Sama. There is no difference. Sama means it is equally there. There is no difference at the time of Paroksha Jnana and at the time of Aparoksha Jnana. The Swayam Prakasha nature, there is no difference in the Swayam Prakasha nature of Atma. So that is how. Paroksha Jnana Kalepi Svaprakashata Sama. It is equally there. Then Brahma Svaprakasham Asti Ityevam Vibodhanat. Brahma is something which is Svaprakasham. That is Asti Ityevam Vibodhanat. Because you are realizing that. You are realizing that, yes, it is always Svaprakasha. Commentary is Paroksha Jnane Iti Aparoksha Jnana Kala Iva. Aparoksha Jnana Kala Iva means Aparoksha Jnana Kale Iva. Just as at the time of Aparoksha Jnana Kala, Paroksha Jnana Kale Api, even at the time of this Paroksha Jnana, even at the time of this indirect knowledge, Vishayasya, what is the Vishaya? Vishayasya Brahmanaha, Brahmana Svaprakashata Asyeva. Vishayasya means Brahmanaha, Svaprakashata Asyeva. That is, Brahma is always self-luminous, always self-evident. Tatra Upapati Maha, Upapati, that is logic. Brahma Svaprakasham Asti Ityevam Vibodhanat. So that is very well known. Is it clear?
Yes.
So basically we can understand it better by taking the 10th man. The 10th man, it was not known. So when somebody said, yes, you are the 10th man, initially the 10th man is there, buddhi. And Paroksha Jnanam is needed. Paroksha Jnanam is not contradicting the Aparoksha Jnanam. So that is it. Then the next shloka, 51st shloka, Avatarika, he is going to say, that what you call as paroksha jnanam may be bhranti also. It may be something which is a false knowledge. Paroksha jnanam, when you say that paroksha jnanam can be bhranti jnanam also. So Siddhanti is saying paroksha jnanam is not bhranti jnanam. When you want to say, so when you want to call something bhranti, it needs some conditions. Suppose you want to say that some knowledge is bhranti or false. If you want to say that, then there should be some conditions for that. Number one, there should be some pramana to say that knowledge is wrong. And he is analyzing that like that. Or you are partly seeing it and partly not seeing it. So like that he is going to explain some conditions. What are the conditions under which you can say that some knowledge is false? And those conditions are not there in the case of Brahman. He is going to say that. In the case of Paroksha Jnana. Paroksha Jnana cannot be called false. Unless these conditions are fulfilled. And what those conditions are not there. That is what he is going to say. I will read the Avatarika. Pratyagabhin abhinna brahma gocharasya jnanasya kutaha parokshatvam iti ashankya pratyagamsha agrahanad ityaha. So okay. Pratyag abhinna brahma gocharasya jnanasya. So this jnanam which has to be understood, this jnanam, what is this jnanam? Pratyag abhinna brahma gocharam. That is, we are realizing that it is not different from me. Pratyag abhinna. Pratyag means what is my own self. Abhinna, this brahma is not different from me. So that is the jnanam. So that particular jnanam, then why parokshatvam? Kutaha parokshatvam? Why this parokshatvam? Iti ashankya. Then why, what is the reply? Pratyagamsha agrahanat. It is not realized as my own self. It is not realized as my own self. So that is the reason why we are talking about paroshatvam. Why do you say that paroshatvam? Paroshatvam is because there are two amshas here. There is Brahma amsha is there, that Pratyagamsha also is there. Brahma amsha is we are okay accepting. But then this Pratyagamsha we are not realizing. So Pratyagamshasya agrahanat. So this is my own self. We are not able to realize it. Ityaha aham brahmeti. So here, let us read the shloka. Aham brahmetyanullikhya brahmastityeva mullikhet parokshajnanametanna bhrantam badhanirupanat. This shloka is slightly complicated. Aham brahma iti anullikhya. Anullikhya means not knowing, not cognizing. You can note down. Anullikhya, ullekhanam. Ullekhanam actually means quoting something. Ullekhanam. Actually, sometimes we use this expression, quoting something. Aham brahma iti anullikhya, that is not knowing or not cognizing that I am Brahman. Brahma asti ityeva mullikhet. A person, Brahma asti, yes, he is only accepting that paroksha jnana. Brahma, yes, it is there. Brahma astitvam, he is saying. Ityeva mullikhet, he knows, he realizes that. Then this particular paroksha jnanam, it is not bhrantam, he says. Paroksha jnanam yetat na bhrantam. So this sort of paroksha jnana cannot be called bhranti. Maybe in the time of Vidyaranya, there might have been several arguments saying that this paroksha jnana is bhranti jnana, etc., etc. So we are not aware of all those arguments. Maybe all those arguments may be in certain higher texts like Advaita Siddhi, etc. So but here, probably he is condensing all those arguments here. So we don't know exactly the context. At that time, there might have been so many arguments. So this paroksha jnana is something which is wrong. It is a false jnana, that is bhranti jnana. So now he is saying, paroksha jnanam etat na bhrantam. Means, etat paroksha jnanam na bhranti jnanam. So that is what is anvaya. Etat paroksha jnanam, this particular type of paroksha jnana is not bhranti jnanam. Why? Badha anirupanat. Badha is what? Badha is negation. Badha is na nirupanat means there is nobody has proved or nobody has negated it. There is no negation for this jnana. So he is saying, he is going to explain. Badhasya anirupanat. Badha anirupanat means badhasya anirupanat. Badha is not proved at all. So though it is, the basic idea is, though it is paroksha, it is not a false knowledge, because there is no proof of negation of that paroksha jnana. There is badha anirupanat means there is no proof of negation of that false knowledge. So I will read the shloka again. Aham brahma iti anullikhya, brahma asti ityeva mulliket. So a person, of course, initially not realizing that aham brahma, he says, yes, brahma asti. So this sort of thing, this paroksha jnanam, yetat paroksha jnanam, na bhrantam. So this particular type of jnana, which is paroksha jnana, it is not a bhranti jnana. Why? Because there is no proof of negation of that false, that particular paroksha jnana. So I will read the commentary. Aham brahma iti, nanu idam bhrantam iti ashankya. So Purvapashi can say, nanu idam bhrantam, yes, what we call paroksha jnanam is something which is bhrantam. Bhrantam means bhranti jnanam, false knowledge. Asya bhrantatvam kim vadhyatvat. So he is giving these four alternatives here. You can call something a bhranti jnanam under four conditions. He is going to say that. Kim vadhyatvat. Vadhyatvat means if it is negated by any pramana. If it is negated by some other pramana, it is called badhyam. Badhyam means something which has been negated, something which has been refuted. Uta. Uta means or. Vyakti anullekhat. Vyakti anullekhat means if it is not directly known at all, under any circumstances it is not directly known at all. But Brahma is directly known after, not by, not every, by everybody, but by people, by jnanis. So vyakti anullekhat. So that is, you can call it bhranti jnanam if it is not known at all. Then number three, athava aparokshena grahana yogyasya parokshena grahanat. Something which has to be known as aparoksha is known as paroksha. Aparokshena grahana yogyasya. That which is capable of being known as aparoksha. Something which is capable of being known as aparoksha is being known as paroksha. So for that reason, are you calling it false? So this is the third count. Fourth count is yadva amsha agrahanat. Amsha agrahanat means part of it is known and part of it is not known. Amsha, amsha means a part. Amsha agrahanat. Amsha is not known. For these reasons, iti chaturdha vikalpya. Chaturdha vikalpya means he has made four alternatives. Who? Vidyaranya. Vidyaranya has made four alternatives, and these four alternatives he is going to discuss in the next four slokas. So that is the point. Chaturdha vikalpya prathamam pratyaha yetaditi. So prathamam thing is refuted here itself. Etaditi, etam na bhrantam, vai badha anirupanat. So this point is being further explained in the next shloka also, the first point. So what he is doing is, what we call as paroksha jnanam is not bhranti jnanam. You can call something as bhranti jnanam under four conditions. That is, number one condition is if it is negated by any pramana, any strong pramana, kim badhyatvat, kuta vyakti anullekhat. Anullekha means if it is not directly known at all. And aparokshena grahana yogyasya parokshena grahanat. That is something which can be directly known. Aparokshena, which can be directly known. Aparokshena grahana yogyasya, something which can be directly known, is not being known directly. And indirectly it is known first. And then yadva amsha grahanat. It is only partly known and partly unknown. So these four conditions he is presuming. And these four conditions are not there in the case of paroksha jnanam of Brahma. So, but that paroksha jnanam is valid. Paroksha jnanam cannot be called bhranti jnanam. So, that is what he is going to say. So, can we go to the next shloka? No, this, chaturdha vikalpya prathamam pratyaha yetaditi yetanna bhrantam. Okay, next shloka. Hetum vivrunoti. So, that particular hetu, badha anirupanat, he said. One small line. So that is being elaborated in this particular shloka. Hetum vivrunoti. So he is going to elaborate on the first point. First point is, there is no pramanam to say that. So if there were to be a pramanam to prove the non-existence of Brahma, then we can say that paroksha jnanam is false. So there is no pramanam to prove the non-existence of Brahma. That is what he is going to say. Brahma nasti iti manam chet syad badhyeta tatha tada dhruvam nacha ivam prabalam manam pashyamoto na badhyate. Brahma nasti iti manam chet Brahma nasti iti kaschit pramanam vartate chet. Suppose there is some strong pramana to say that Brahma is not at all there. Then syat badhyeta tada dhruvam badhyeta. Yes, surely it will be negated. Chet syat. See, if it is so, then it will happen. Badhyeta tada dhruvam. Dhruvam means surely it will be negated. But nachaivam prabalam manam pasyamaha. Nacha evam prakarena prabalam manam. Manam means pramanam. Mana is pramanam. This sort of prabalam manam na pasyamaha. We may be listening to some weak arguments from atheists and people like that. But it is not a prabalam manam. Prabalam manam is very strong argument. There is no strong argument because the Shruti is saying that yes, there is Brahma. And then there is so much of logic behind it. So when somebody says, okay, some Nastikavadi or somebody says Brahma Nasti, it is not a prabalam manam. Prabalam manam is Shruti only. Upanishad is the prabalam pramanam. Then nachaivam prabalam manam pasyamaha ato na badhyate, therefore it is not negated. So the first point is badhyatvat. If it is badhyam, then it becomes false knowledge. It is not badhyam. So it is not na badhyate. So the four, out of the four conditions, the first condition is not there. Then the second condition, what was that? Second condition was vyakti anullekhad. Anullekhad means it is not directly known at all. So that is it. So that condition also is being refuted. Vyakti anulleka, dvitiyam atiprasangena dushayati. That second argument also, he is finding fault with that second condition also. How? Vyakti anulleka matrena brahmatve swargadhirapi. Bhrantisyad vyakti anullekhat samanyolleka darshanat. Then vyakti anulleka matrena, by merely saying that it is something which is not directly known. Vyakti anulleka. Vyakti means a particular vishaya. Anulleka means not directly known, not directly knowing. So vyakti anulleka matrena, by mere non-cognition of a particular thing. Then brahmatve, if you want to say that it is brahma, brahmatve means brahmatve sati. If brahma, not even brahmatve sati, brahmatve ukte sati. If you want to say, if you want to allege that it is brahma, then swargadhirapi. Swargadhirapi means the knowledge of swarga also bhranti hisyat. So that knowledge of swarga also will become a bhranti. Bhranti siyat. Why? Vyakti anullekhat. Because that swarga also is not seen by us. Vyakti anullekhat. Then samanyolleka darshanat. Samanyena, in the entire world is accepting. Samanya ulleka darshanat. Generally it is known. Generally it is accepted. But not directly seen. Samanya ulleka darshanat. Samanyolleka is very much there for swarga. But you are not directly seeing it. So for the point that it is not directly seen, it is not an argument to say that parosha jnana is a false jnana. Parosha jnana cannot be a false jnana. If you want to say that all parosha jnana is false jnana, you have to say that swarga jnana also is a false jnana. So, but swarga jnana is not a false jnana, it is generally accepted by everybody. Of course, he could also have said, this paroksha jnanam, the second condition, what was that second condition? That is, it is not directly known, isn't it? Vyakti anullekhat. He also could have said, yes, there are so many realized people. In their case, they are realizing. They are directly realizing. So that also he could have told. We don't know why he has not told, but he has only told about swarga. So don't you see that point here?
Yeah.
Because there are so many people, for example, Vamadeva. We hear about Vamadeva who said, yes, aham manu rabhavam. I am Manu, I am everything, I am infinity. He said that. And Shuka Maharshi and all these people, there are so many examples in our Vedanta literature. So it is Vyakti Anulleka, it doesn't arise at all in the case of Brahma. Vyakti Anulleka, that is not cognizing, it is not arising. That also could have told. But he is giving another argument, that is vyakti anulleka matrena brahmatve. If you want to say that when it is not directly known, it is also brahma, then swarga, the knowledge of swarga also has to become brahma. So that is what he said. Okay, commentary. ayam swarga ityeva ityeva makareṇa grahana bhavat ayam swarga ityeva makareṇa grahana bhavat. Yes, nobody is able to say yes, this is what is swargam, I have seen, etc. Kintu swarga asti ityevam, but all said and done, they say yes, swarga is there. Samanya karena pratitehe, so generally it is accepted. Generally it is accepted. Swarga buddhi rapi brahmatva prasangaha. Then if you want to say that whatever is not directly seen is all Brahma, then you will have to say that swarga also is Brahma. So that we don't take that condition. So that is what he is saying. Then the third point was aparochena grahana yogyasya parochena grahana. Something which is capable of being known by, which can be known as aparoksha, it is known as paroksha. So that thing can be bhranti jnana. So that was the argument. Trutiyam nirakaroti. So that trutiya argument also he is refuting. Then aparokshatva yogyasya na parokshamadir brahmaha parokshamityanullekhat arthat parokshya sambhavat. This is again slightly, we have to understand it slowly. So, for example, suppose you take, before explaining this shloka, I will give an example. For example, there is a ghatam. So, there is ghatamasti. Ghatamasti, initially, suppose some paroksha jnanam is there. And when ghatam is seen, somebody says ghatamasti. I have not seen it is paroksha jnanam. And I see it becomes pratyaksha jnanam, not aparoksha jnanam. It is pratyaksha jnanam. It is in front of my eye. I am not becoming the cup. Then, paroksha jnanam, this sort of paroksha jnanam, so long as I see, it can be wrong, isn't it? Paroksha jnanam, so long as I don't see at all, it may be there, it may not be there. It can be vranti. But in the case of Brahma, what is it? Brahma asti, but not realized. So that is at that level it is called paroksha jnanam. Then Brahma, when it is realized, it becomes aparoksha jnanam only. Then this paroksha jnanam cannot be wrong because you are always there. So Brahma, in the case of Brahma, this paroksha jnanam cannot be wrong because you are always there. You are never disappearing. Paroksha jnanam, this Brahma, ahamasmi, that is aparoksha jnanam. And even at the time of paroksha jnanam, aham Brahma asmi holds good, isn't it? When I am saying Brahma asti, even then aham Brahma asmi eva. Even when I am saying Brahma asti, then Brahma asmi eva. Even an atheist, when he says yes, there is no God, even then he is Brahma only. Somebody, some nastika, comes and says there is no God, etc., etc., he is also Brahma Swarupa. He is also only Brahma Swarupa. Foolishly he is saying yes, there is no Brahma, etc., etc. So that is the point. So, in the case of an ordinary object, paroksha jnanam can be mithya. But in the case of Brahma, it cannot be mithya. Because in the case of Brahma, I am asmi, when I say I am asmi, aparoksha jnanam, okay, that is fine. Even that paroksha jnanam also, it cannot be mithya because even when I say Brahma asti, that Brahma asmi eva, I don't cease to exist, I don't disappear anywhere. I is very much there. So that is the point. So trutiyam nirakaroti. So the aparokshatva yogyasya na parokshamatir brahmaha parokshamityanullekhad arthat parokshya sambhavat. So let us see this thing. Aparokshatva yogyasya vastunaha. That is aparokshatvena jnatum yogyasya vastunaha. That is Brahma which can be known as aparoksham. Is it clear? Aparokshasya, aparokshatvena jnatum yogyasya vastunaha. We can elaborate like that. That is some vastu which can be known as aparoksha, which can be known directly. So for that Brahma, in other words, Brahma, Brahmanaha, parokshamatihi. Parokshamatihi means paroksha jnanam. Mati means jnanam. Parokshamatihi. Brahmaha na bhavati. Na parokshamatir brahmaha. Parokshamatihi brahma na. Brahma na means brahma na bhavati. Brahmanaha paroksha jnanam brahma na bhavati. That is the simple meaning of the first line. If you want, you can write down also. Brahmanaha paroksha jnanam brahma na bhavati. Brahmaha na bhavati. So something like that you can write down. Brahmanaha, that is aparokshatva yogyasya, for the entire thing the meaning is Brahmanaha. Brahmanaha paroksha matihi means paroksha jnanam, brahma na bhavati. Then paroksha mityanullekhat, brahma is not proved as paroksha. Paroksha, you see, any other object you can prove it as paroksha. Yes, everything is there, it is there, it may exist, it may not exist. But brahma is not established as proved as paroksha. That is, nobody has seen it objectively. Nobody has seen it as an objective, as an object. As in the case of Swarga, brahma is not like that. It is not established like as in the case of Swarga. Then why do you say that paroksham means that indirect nature? Paroksha is indirect, paroksham means indirect nature. The next point is arthat parokshya sambhavat, that indirectness, paroksham, you can write as indirectness. I did not see Swahananda what he has written. Paroksha is indirectness. That indirectness is only because of usage. Because arthat means only according to the context, only because of the usage. Arthat here means only because of the context, only because of usage, we are saying that arthat. When we say Brahma Asti, it sounds like Paroksha Jnana. When we say Brahma Asti, it sounds like Paroksha Jnana. So that is the arthat. Arthat means that is the when you are using that expression Brahma Asti, it looks like Paroksha Jnana. So that's all. Aparokshatva Yogyasya, that is Brahmanaha, Paroksha Matihi, that is Paroksha Jnanam, Brahma Nabhavati, that is the first line. Parokshamit Yanullekhat, because Brahma is never known as Paroksha. You cannot say this is Brahma. Suppose you hold, yes, this is what is Brahma, you cannot show it. When you say Ghataha Asti, you can show, yes, this is Ghatam. But in the case of Brahma, you cannot say this is Brahma. So that is the point. Paroksham iti anullekhat. Then paroksham, how does this paroksham come? Paroksham arthat paroksha sambhavat. Arthat, by virtue of this context, by virtue of this usage, this indirectness has come into that Brahma. So that is what he says. Let us see the commentary. Commentary, if you read, it will be clear. Brahmatva, yeah. Trutiyam nirakaroti aparokshatva iti. Aparokshatvena grahana yogya pratyagabhinna brahma vishayasya. So what is this aparokshatvena grahana yogyam? Something which can be known. Grahana yogyam means something which can be known as aparoksha, as my own self. What is that? Pratyagabhinna brahma vishayasya. That is that pratyagabhinna brahma is what is that aparokshena grahana yogyam. For that, paroksha jnanasya brahmatvam na sambhavati. Of that brahma, paroksha jnanam cannot become Brahma, it cannot become false. Why? He is saying, kutaha ityaha parokshamiti. Brahma parokshamiti evam akarena grahana abhavat. Brahma is never known as paroksham. Yes, this is what is Brahma. You are not showing it. You are not showing it as, yes, this is what is Brahma. You cannot show it. Parokshamiti evam akarena grahana abhavat. Then kutasarhitasya parokshatam. Then why are you saying it is paroksha? We are also saying it is paroksha. On one hand we are saying that is paroksha is not there. Again you are saying it is Brahma paroksha jnana level also you are saying. Kutaha paroksatvam iti ashankyaha. Arthat means by virtue of that context. What? Idam brahma ityeva vyakti ulleka bhava samarthyat. Idam brahma ityeva vyakti ulleka abhava samarthyat. You cannot show that, yes, this is Brahma. You cannot show like that. Vyakti ullekhanam. Ullekhanam means knowing, cognizing something as that. Yes, this is what is Brahma. Nobody can cognize and then say, samarthyat parokshatva siddhihi. That is the reason why you are saying that is parokshatva. You are saying this, like you say, when you say Brahma asti, it is sounding like paroksha jnanam. It is sounding like paroksha jnanam, but Brahma is not really paroksham. Brahma is not really paroksham, it is sounding like paroksha jnanam. You are just, in order to understand it better, you are saying, okay, initially there is what is called a vrutti, etc., brahmakara vrutti. Even when that brahmakara vrutti takes place, even then Brahma is aparoksham only. You are only by virtue of that Brahmakara Vritti, you are only saying yes, it is Parosha. Initially that Parosha Jnanam and later Aparosha Jnanam. We are using it like that. Arthat Paroksha Sambhavat. Vyakti Ullekha Bhava Samarthyat Parokshatva Siddhihi Iti Bhavaha. So this is a slightly complicated shloka. Complicated means the third condition which is being refuted. That is something which can be known as Aparoksha. If it is initially understood as Paroksha, that Paroksha Jnanam is not false. Because this is always Aparoksha. Aparokshatvam you cannot negate. Aparokshatvam it is always there. So, for that, initially you are saying, yes, Brahma Asti. Later you are knowing, yes, I am that tenth man. So, tenth man example comes into, becomes useful for this. Then the fourth condition was Amsha Agrahanam, partly known, knowing and partly not knowing. So for this, he is going to say that nobody knows all the aspects of all, even in ordinary life. Suppose I take a pot, I take a ghatam. I know only this portion, I don't know what is here. And unless I look into, I don't know what is inside. When you see any object also, you only know something, only one portion, and you don't know all other portions. So he is giving that example. Amsha Agrahanam is there everywhere. So that is what he says. So Amsha, because Amsha Agrahanam is there, you can't say that that knowledge is false. That is what he says. Then Charamam Ashankate. Charamam means the last one. Charama. Charamam, shall we say? Charama, Charamada, shall we say? That last stage. Charamam Ashankate means that last option he is discussing. Amshagruhitir bhrantischet ghatajnanam bhramo bhavet niramshasyapi samshatvam vyavartyamsha vibhedatah. So there are 2 points which he is saying here. Amsha agruhitihi bhrantischet. If you want to say that partial knowledge is bhranti, amsha agruhitihi. That is partial knowledge. In other words, partial knowledge. Non-cognition of part of it. You can say both ways. Non-cognition of part of it or you can say partial knowledge. If you say that partial knowledge is what is called bhranti, bhrantischet, ghatajnanam bhramo bhavet. Ghatajnanam also becomes brahma. Because ghatam also, you are not saying, you know, you are not seeing it in all aspects. You are seeing only one aspect. You are only seeing the one portion and then you are saying it is ghatam. So, ghatajnanam also becomes bhranti. So, you should not say that because of that amsha agrahanam, you can't say that it is false. Then, you can say, then a question may arise. But Brahma is niramsha, isn't it?
Yeah.
How can you compare it with a samsha? This is samsha. Brahma is niramsha. So how can you compare it with a ghata which has got parts? So that question may arise. For that he is answering in the next line. Niramshasya api samshatvam. Why are we saying this samshatvam? Niramshasya brahmanaha. Samshatvam vayam vadamaha. Though Brahma is niramsha, we are talking as though it is samsha. Why? Vyavartyamsha vibhedatah. In Brahma, in that also, there is what is called vyavartyamsha. So this Jiva is there. This Jiva is a complex. Is a complex of, there is something called Brahma and Abrahma. Sat, Asat. So Asat Vyavrutti. Asat Vyavrutti means that Asat you have to negate. Asat you have to take off. Once that Asat you take off, then only Sat remains. So the Brahma also, in this particular context, there is what is called a Vyavartyamsa. In the context of a Jiva. When you are referring to Brahma alone, there is no Vyavartyamsa. When you are referring to Brahma alone, there is no Vyavartyamsa. But you are referring to Jiva here. You are referring to Jiva where there is a combination of Chit and Achit. So that Vyavartyamsa is very much there. So when Jiva is saying, I am Brahma, then there is a Vyavartyamsa very much there. So after that he is taken away, then he is very much Brahma. So that is the point.
Vyavarta is related to Vivarta also?
No. Vivarta is different. That is Vividham, Vivarta is something different. Vivarta is, you see, Parinama and Vivarta, these technical words. Parinama is, suppose I melt it, it becomes molten and then I may change it into something else. So that is Parinama. Vivarta means the original thing doesn't undergo any change. That is like a rope snake. That rope doesn't undergo any change. Whereas you are seeing a garland, you are seeing some sort of bhu chidra, you are seeing a snake. So vivarta, the original thing does not undergo any change. The kutastha does not undergo any change. But it appears like a change. So that is what is, that is the thing. That is the reason why we have postulated that maya. Because Brahma is something which is kutastha. And you have to explain all this phenomenal world. Then how are you going to explain the phenomenal world? You have to accept some postulation called, something called a hypothesis called maya. We can call it a hypothesis. There is no, nothing wrong. Because there is no other way you can say. Otherwise you have to say, yes, there is a person called God. That person called God is somewhere sitting in, somewhere in the space. Somewhere in the space there is some loka. So something like that we have to say. So we cannot say that. Upanishads do not say that. Yeah. Upanishads say, yes, that is only, it is manifesting. There is something, it is a, there is a manifesting power in that consciousness. So that is what we say. So that, then how to account for that? Then that Brahma or whatever it is, consciousness, it has got some sort of manifesting power. And we are calling it something which is inexplicable. That is anirvachaniya. And that is what is maya. And that maya, is it totally false? It is not false also. It is bhava rupam says. Bhava rupam is, it cannot be negated. Satasadhyam anirvachaniyam. You cannot say it is sat or whether it is asat. But its effect or effect is there. Bhava rupam, its effects are seen. There is a phenomena. So that is the point. So vyavarta is different. Vyavartanam is removing, negating. So we'll quickly see this thing. Is the time over?
Yeah.
Over? Yes. Or still 1 or 2 more minutes?
No.
Then we'll see the, read the shloka again tomorrow. Harihi Om Tatsat.